My name is Dr. Huma Hassan and I am going to give orientation to anthropology syllabus and to anthropology specifically for UPSC aspirants. So one of the major questions or the frequent question which I always come and aspirants ask me two things. That ma'am, I am from science background, I want to take anthropology, so will it be helpful? Those who come from social science background, they say ma'am, because since in anthropology we have a biological anthropology also, it talks about genes and all, so will it be helpful for us? My answer is to all those things that anthropology has a crispy syllabus. It has if you see only the anthropology syllabus in UPSC, it talks about I'll just show you. It talks about meaning and nature of anthropology, then the scope, and then it just talk about biological evolution, then it will talk about society, culture, if I just define the subject matter of anthropology, it is a holistic study of human mankind. When I'm saying holistic study, it means that since human beings have evolved and even today, what type of implication they are facing, be it biological changes and also the changes which we can see in their social cultural life. It's about that. It is a very interesting subject and very scoring as well if you know the right strategy. Okay, so I would say whether you are science background, non-science background, it all matters here. It is there. I would say what you will think. And the way you make the plan and if you'll execute, nothing is impossible in life. Okay, so I would say that if you can see on your screen, it is about biological evolution. Okay, so how from primates we become Homo erectus, Homo sapiens sapiens, and if you see these two people here, it's telling something different. It's showing that female is bald, he is also bald, so they are both are not wearing clothes, she is wearing some ornaments, he is also wearing. Okay, so it talks about culture and what type of culture? Indigenous culture. So there is a there is one you can say one confusion which people thought that anthropology is study of indigenous people or the tribal people or the Adivasis. No, somehow you can say that it started with the study of tribal people or the forest dwellers, but now various corporate world also is like hiring anthropologists to even to before they're launching their products, they want anthropologists to have a study on their product and how it's going to sell their product in the market. Because anthropologists have a diverse understanding. They do have understanding of different races in India, in the world. And, see the branches of anthropology. It talks about physical anthropology or biological anthropology. It talks about linguistic, the languages which we have. It talks about social cultural anthropology. It talks about, what not. In anthropology, the very first benefit of yours can be, which you will see the last year. Last year the topper was from anthropology, but this is not the reason I'm saying this. What I'm trying to tell you is that the questions are direct. Here you do not have to understand like the way in sociology people do, that they want to have to have understanding of theories. So here you can also have applied anthropology. Some questions will be from biological anthropology. So there in the biological anthropology, what is the trick? You just need to prepare your answer in bullet points for 150 words and also for the 250, 250 something. So there you can, the moment you start your preparation for anthropology, separate biological anthropology and make your notes and start learning them and start practicing them. Then you have some portion from archaeological anthropology and everything. So I'll explain that in detail in a while. Okay, so I'm just showing that we have diverse planets, we have diverse things, but Earth is a special unique planet. Why? In Earth we have North America, South America, Africa, Middle East, Asia, Europe, Australia, all this place. You'll see here, you can see these people, he's different from him, these people are different from each other. So they have different genes, they have different race, they have different culture. But we are going to have studies, and anthropology actually gives us diverse perception. So if we think that our world is real world, we will have other world. People, they have also evolved roughly at the same time because we all are human species. But how we are different, that's what we study. So I would say that anthropology is indeed a very good subject. Take it, it's going to be helpful. And one thing I would say, it's personal, people can differ from my opinion. Often people say that take your option if you have interest. Recently there was a person whom I was watching an interview of. He had a mathematics. I'm not saying those who are taking mathematics, they are doing wrong. I'm just telling that in that video, that person has told. So this person was have recently sit for interview, and he said that it was his sixth attempt in which he was facing interview, and every time he had clear prelims, every time he had written mains. Okay, and he says that when we take optional, it should not only be of interest, it should be also, you need to see about the marking things. And I also have the similar opinion. I say that take your optional, which is going to be helpful in your other subjects too. Okay, if you think that you are too good in the static subjects, take that. I'm not saying anything to them. But the thing is that you need to see that you're not going to do masters in this subject. Maybe future you can do. Maybe you can do doctorate in that. Then that's a different story altogether. But here the focal point is that we have to see our name in the list. That's it. So choose your option which is scoring for you. Choose your option which will minimize your stress. Okay, and I think anthropology and another, it's sociology, then of course it's history because it also talks about society and all. Then also, I mean, see, these are the three subjects which is very much related with your current affairs and thing, you can correlate it. Okay, so here I would just say that, you know, in this picture you can see that diverse people have different culture, different society, biologically they have like, you know, different genes. We are going to study that in anthropology. So this is a roughly subject matter of anthropology. So you must have understanding what is the root of anthropology, why entering subject is difficult, that I would say. Because one thing, a common mistake people do, they start with the advanced level of book. So koi top karta hai, wo kisi book publication ke sath collaborate karke books market mein leke aate hai, kisi ke notes rakhe hai, hame lagta hai ki easy to handle sab kuch hai, to hum pad lete hai, likh lete hai, that's it. No. Conceptual understanding is the only key where you can get a good mark in any subject. It has to be your origin. Refer to these notes. I'm not saying refer to these books, but it should be only for reference and make a systematic approach. So one thing people just do not do, that is one book which you, I would say, it is a SCRT Anthropology class 11 and class 12. None of the questions were out of these two books. And it is very easy to buy. I mean, I think it's not available in the market, in so-called UPSC market. It's not there. So you have to download. Okay, it's a Kerala book, Kerala board. So download that book, class 11, class 12, and just read them at least thrice. So you win this race after making, note making is your tool. After note making, you, if I'll just say that what are the tips, okay, I would say have a clear-cut understanding on anthropologists and their theories. Start writing your answer, make interconnection, interdisciplinary, and put current affairs. Okay, do not fill everyone's pocket. You may think that, ma'am, aap kaun sa lag kar rahe ho, you are also doing the same. No. Later on, it will people will come to know what I aspire to do, and I do not have to prove myself. But I would say that how you can have understanding if your concepts are clear, and concepts can be clear only if you have proper understanding of these books. So I can show you these books only. Also, please wait for a while. So we have two books, class 11 and class 12. One book I have uploaded and I'm uploading another book too. So now it's going to be open on your screen. This is a book. This is class 12, okay. See the previous year question of 2021 and see these two topics and just see the subheadings. None of the questions were out of this book. All the questions were from this book. One or two were from applied anthropology. I mean, all the questions were from these books. And it is a ready-made notes and very costly. I mean, very cheap, not costly. Itna zyada costly hai na har jage, so it's just like that. So it's very cheap. It's available on PDF. You just have a PDF and take out the printouts. Okay, and if you are comfortable with marking the digital, have a Microsoft Edge on your laptop and underline them. Okay, so it's very easy, very, very, very easy. You will have some basic notes here already in a note manner. So like, what is anthropology? You have here, you can see, anthropology is a discipline upholds human diversity. Okay, anthropology is as a discipline upholds human diversity as it is a reality which need to be appreciated and accepted. Okay, so anthropology was first coined by Aristotle. So such very basic information is there. You do not have to work too hard, okay? And I'm again repeating myself, if you are reading anyone's notes, in future you will also see my notes too. Do not refer like that. This is that notes are mine. It can only give you guidance, and that guidance can only come if you have a conceptual understanding. That's it, okay? So these are the major branches: biological anthropology, social cultural anthropology, archaeological anthropology, linguistic anthropology. So it is a unique subject. Anthropology is indeed a unique subject because it deals with everything. Aristotle rightly said that it is like, it's a gossip of humankind. Anthropology loves humankind and he can talk and he's in a true love with humankind. Okay? So I would just say, please take these two books right now and you can have an understanding on this. It is there free of cost. This is what I have marked. If I can give in writing if you want, and I will just write this, that if you people have studied these two books, and it is not mine, I'm not promoting any book. It is like SERT, it's a government book. It's just like, if you read these two books, your foundation of anthropology will be strongest. Okay? And this is my signature. So this is what I would say. Okay? So now let's just come back to our PPT. So you can see this is the roots of anthropology, in which you have to understand that how it has come up, what is the definition. It is a science of men in which we are understanding every aspect of human mankind. Okay, so that is of anthropology. You need to have some understanding on it, just start making notes. So what is the outcome of the subject? This is what I have just decided, and it is of social cultural anthropology, that human species are different because he knows the ability to take care of others. In this particular slide which you can see, I'm just talking about Margaret Mead. She's a very important anthropologist. She said that human civilization have started when we found a femur. There was a heel femur, okay, it is of thigh bone. We have found it was broken. And naturally, in a forest setting, in a hunting-gathering society, or when we were a primitive society, when we were living in the forest society and we were dependent on our environment directly, even today we are dependent on them. But it says if animals have a broken leg or something like that, so sooner or later he will die because somebody will come and eat him. Okay, but with humans, it means that if there was a broken femur, if agar kisi ka tongue toot chuka tha, so there was somebody who looked after him. So human civilization actually started when you can see that femur had that found. So this is a very, very good understanding of humanity, and this is why anthropologists are being hired, everywhere, okay? So the scope of anthropologist for job opportunities is very high. So indicates that someone has helped a fellow human rather than abandoning them to save their own life. So conceptual understanding is very clear, and for conceptual understanding I have just told you that I have recommended that book. Okay, so there are too many for physical anthropology I would say that PNR, but not compulsory. I just say these two books will be enough. And physical anthropology, I'm not here providing my notes to everyone, but I can just show you that PPT whenever I will have a discussion. You can see on from my PPT that how you have to make the notes, and if you want to buy, again, you can buy PNR notes, but I will say that depend more on articles and not on the articles which you will see from this coaching industries. I'm not talking about those articles, okay? I'm talking about scholarly articles, like on the website like Academia, okay, Economical Political Weekly, on Telegram group, newspapers. These are the sources in which you can understand this type of information. So this is a syllabus, as I was saying, that in first you will see it talks about meaning and scope and development of anthropology, then how it's related, then the main branches. Okay, then here it's a biological part, human evolution and emergence of man. Okay, then you will see that what is the phylogenetic status, geographical distribution of the following and all. Then you will see the 1.4 in here, you will talk about that evolution of primates, mammals and all. And then we have how the culture evolution. So now it is part of social anthropology. Okay, then we have a family, concept of kinship, marriage, study of social cultural change, then concept of society. So it is also for your because this is what I was saying, that only the anthropology syllabus is like that, where it is very confusing where to what study and all. Okay, so it is like that. And paper 2 is all about Indian society, and most of the questions come last year. It was from tribal anthropology. Take paper 2 very seriously. It is not going to help only in your paper 2, also in essay, also in ethics, also in interview, in the paper 1 and whatnot, because it is dealing with Indian society. Okay, so how we can comprehend the syllabus? So I would say that syllabus copy has to be there with all of you. You need to have overall viewpoint of the topic. Make small understanding of your topic, of your syllabus. This is a tip that whatsoever you can understand, sit with your anthropology syllabus for a while, one or two or three sittings. Just understand them as a whole, what large institution it is giving us. And also have the case studies. Case studies like, you know, how Bills tribes are doing, what is Orient tribes or Santhal tribes, what is the Khasi tribes, and you know, their institutions, what they are doing. So that is a case studies that you know them in and out. So their political, social, cultural life, everything. So syllabus is very interesting and very interesting. It's small and manageable. Okay, so those who have prior of biology, history, sociology can relate with the syllabus at first, but it is applied anthropology, it is Indian society features. Whether you are from science, non-science background, doesn't matter. So what I would say, that start early as possible. Handwritten notes, of course, has to be there. In-depth readings, answer writing. Practicing answer writing is of utmost importance, will take time and deserve your time. Though everybody knows the answer, but only few knows how to frame it. So this is what I would say. For your part, I divide sociology in anthropology in this heading: biological anthropology, social cultural anthropology, Indian society. And Indian society is caste, religion, villages, linguistics, culture. And this is very important, tribal communities, the projects and the recent affairs which is happening related to these groups and anthropological theories. Okay, then we have biological anthropology. Then further biological anthropology is divided into traditional physical anthropology and new physical anthropology. So traditional physical anthropology was just like a biological science. Okay, where we were understanding fossil evidences, evolution of human being, the differences of the brain, fossils and all. Now physical anthropology or biological anthropology is a applied manner. So new physical anthropology, you can see that physical anthropology is a biological science that deals with the adaptation, variability and evolution of human beings and their living and fossil relatives. So because it studies human biology in the context of human culture, behavior, physical anthropology is also a social science. So this is the current style of dealing with physical anthropology all over the world. So I have just defined all this. So you can say biological basis of life, human genetics, Mendelian genetics in man's family studies, concept of genetic polymorphism and selection, chromosomes and chromosomal aberration. This year one question came, age, sex, population variation. So these are the things for biological anthropology. So race and racism, human growth and development, demographic theories, profile, application of anthropology. Okay, so yahan pe aapka syllabus cover up ho jata hai. To humko anthropology ke syllabus ko debunk karna padta hai, usko systematic rational way mein arrange karna hota hai. And then social anthropology, it's a nature of culture, society, marriage, family, kinship, marriage and all. Economic anthropology, political anthropology, and these are the central topics of paper 2. Varna, ashram, caste system, varna ashram pe is bari question aaya tha, caste mein bhi aaya tha, impact of different religions in Indian societies, Indian villages, linguistic and religious minorities, indigenous and exogenous process of social cultural change. Indigenous changes jo India mein, India se originate hai, exogenous jo bahar se hai. So indigenous India mein kaise kaun se changes the? Sanskritization hua, Buddhism aaya, Jainism aaya, exosikism, exogenous, modernization, westernization and all. And the tribal communities are utmost important, and research method again very important, but this year the tradition have little change, not many questions have come from research part. And anthropological theories are again another section which you need to understand. Okay, so which thinker is saying what? Okay, that is you need to understand. And this is the thinkers which you, for example, Levi-Strauss is using structural functionalism, and he's basically structuralist. So he's saying that we need to understand the structure of society. So he has used the binary vision. He says that everything exists in the opposites. So day hai, din hai, you know, day, night, good, bad. Okay, and he talks about that there is an evolution of society. For example, earlier we were savage, then we little become barbaric, and then we become civilized. Okay, then there are different other theories who talks about, for example, Malinowski. Malinowski has brought a paradigm shift in the studies of anthropological theories. He said that we need to have a participatory approach, ethnographic approach to understand different culture. So these are the cultures which you need to understand very briefly. Okay, what Levi-Strauss is saying, what is Morgan is saying on family institution, for example, for Kathleen Goh, she is saying that actually to understand family institution, we need to understand that the end result is that female lives with their children, and this is the reality of family. Okay, and then for example, there is Robin Fox. He says that marriage institution family, it comes only because of incest taboo. So what is incest taboo? Incest taboo is a rule and regulation to have a marital or to have a sexual relationship. Whom you can have sex, whom you can marry, with whom you can't. Okay, so it's actually created other institution. So you need to have a crispy or good understanding of anthropology. आप इतनी बड़ी बड़ी theories पढ़ के एक answer बनाओगे, उसको रटोगे, लिखोगे, ऐसा नहीं करना है. Theories को अपने words में, अगर मान लो आपने, let's just say आपने 5 पेजेस में कोई थ्योरी समझी है तो आपको 50 वर्ड्स में उस थ्योरी को एक्सप्लेन करना है। फॉर एग्जांपल, एक बहुत फेमस थ्योरी का नाम मैं बताती हूँ क्योंकि इसके बारे में हम सभी को पता होता है, कार्ल मार्क्स। कार्ल मार्क्स की थ्योरी है ऑफ कास्ट एंड स्ट्रगल, कन्फ्लिक्ट पर्सपेक्टिव। इसको आपको एक लाइन में बताना है। कार्ल मार्क्स का कहना है दैट देयर इज अ कन्फ्लिक्ट। कन्फ्लिक्ट का क्या मतलब होता है? क्लैश ऑफ इंटरेस्ट। क्लैश ऑफ इंटरेस्ट किस में है? दोज हु ओन्स अ मीन्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन, लाइक कैपिटलिस्ट, जिनके पास जो फैक्ट्रीज को ओन करते हैं और जो उस फैक्ट्री में अपने लेबर को सेल करते हैं। सो दोज हु सेल देयर लेबर, दे आर द वन, एंड देयर इज अ सोसाइटी इज नथिंग बट टू अंडरस्टैंड कन्फ्लिक्ट बिटवीन दिस टू। ओके, सो दिस इज अ थ्योरी, एंड फॉर एंड when you are understanding Karl Marx in the books, there's a communist manifesto, there's a class struggle, there's a alienation, there's a family, for example, the religion. For us, religion is a binding force, integrating force, it makes us together. हमें religion जोड़ता है, हम लोग यहाँ पर emotionally connect होते हैं। जब भी हमें stressful situation में होते हैं, हम supernatural things के ऊपर अपना belief रखते हैं। तो ये क्या है? ये very simple thing in which we try to correlate ourselves. So this is a theory of supernatural. So supernatural things को हम जब believe करते हैं, तो it is a concept of animism. So it is a concept of animism जो कि Edward Taylor ने start किया है, आप कह सकते हैं उन्होंने इस पर बहुत अच्छा काम किया है। देन इमाइल डरकम, इस साल भी इस पर क्वेश्चन आया है। सो बट देन व्हाट कार्ल मार्क्स इज सेइंग, कार्ल मार्क्स इज सेइंग दैट रिलीजन इज नथिंग बट इट्स इल्यूजन फॉर द मासेस। ओके, सो व्हाई इट सेज लाइक दैट? इट सेज दैट बिकॉज इल्यूजन इज वेरी ओपेक, इट्स डजंट गिव एनीथिंग, इट इज क्रिएटेड ओनली टू टेल एंड टू हैव टू कंटिन्यू देयर एक्सप्लॉयटेशन। Religion is there just to say workers that, you know, in the past life you must have done something good, so you really have to contribute, and maybe after life there will be a there will be a hell, there will be a paradise and all that. Okay, so Karl Marx says that religion is a opium of masses. It's an illusion. It is, nothing is created, nothing is good here. So this is kind of theory which you have to understand in anthropology. So this is what I would say. And you need to see that first part can be the social cultural anthropology, Indian culture and society, tribals and other marginalized sections, then evolution of culture and physical, and then physical biological anthropology. So generally I do this, that I take biological anthropology in the end, because it is of very much like, you know, you just do not have, you cannot understand Mendelian theory again and again. It is very simple. Okay, you chromosome aberration, for example, the cells revision, what is happening, what is epidemiological anthropology, like, you know, medicine's anthropology. In that, you know, it is a very also current affair, because now the question is coming from new physical anthropology. So some concepts you need to just mug it up, you need to understand. So for that, I would say that PNR book is very heavy, and you just, I mean, it's sometimes too much. So do not wait, I mean, like totally depend on them. So I think that after 4 months, you can just correlate this. But I generally believe that you must study those two books, first of all, just to have understanding. And then you should start your preparation. Okay, so this is what I would say, and this is the orientation. So again, I have just divided this syllabus. Okay, so I would say that it's a process. Try to understand that nothing will come in one go. You need to sit with syllabus, you have to have a clear understanding, you need to understand the concepts in a deeper manner, and then try to apply it in answer writing, because you cannot produce everything in whatever you know. So some lectures I'm going to talk about answer writing, that the moment you have finished class 11, class 12, and some PPT or some books which I would recommend to you, start writing your answer. Because you can win this if you have multiple revisions, and that revision also has to be very systematic. Okay, you need to write and then get evaluated it. Do not just think on your own that you have written a really good marks. Evaluate it by somebody. It can be your seniors, but just try to understand who is your senior. Okay, you need to invest that whom you are trusting. Have a critical understanding of your thought process. ओके, तो ये बहुत कुछ बातें हैं जो हमें एंथ्रोपोलॉजी के लिए समझना चाहिए, और ये रीज़न नहीं होना चाहिए किसी ने टॉप किया है तो आप भी टॉप कर सकते हो उसमें। हाँ, ये एंथ्रो सोशो या किसी ने टॉप किया तो आप देख सकते हो कि ये थोड़ा ऐसा ईजी है, सोशल साइंस से बहुत ज़्यादा रिलेटेड है ये सब्जेक्ट, तो आपको कैसे हेल्प करना है आपकी खुद की एक स्ट्रैटेजी होनी चाहिए। ठीक है, 6 to 7 hours अगर आप पढ़ रहे हैं और उसमें आप स्ट्रैटेजी के साथ पढ़ रहे हैं, तो ये बहुत मुश्किल नहीं है। ओके सो दैट्स व्हाट आई वुड से. और दूसरी बात ये कहूँगी कि मैं प्रिलिमिनरी मेंस और इंटरव्यू के साथ साथ प्रिपरेशन करिए. ऐसा मत सोचिए कि प्रिलिमिनरी पहले क्लियर होगा फिर उसके बाद आप मेंस की प्रिपरेशन करेंगे फिर आप इंटरव्यू की प्रिपरेशन करेंगे. डोंट डू दैट. हैव अ कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव एंड इंटरकनेक्टेड लाइक यू नो प्रिपरेशन फॉर दिस. सो थैंक यू सो मच. आई थिंक आई हैव गिवन अ ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट एंथ्रोपोलॉजी, वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी एंड वॉट नॉट. इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन मोर ऑन सिलेबस ऑफ एंथ्रोपोलॉजी एंड आई वुड जस्ट स्टार्ट विद द मीनिंग एंड नेचर ऑफ एंथ्रोपोलॉजी. ओके सो दिस इज इट आई वुड सजेस्ट. एंड द टू बुक्स विच आई हैव लाइक यू नो शोन, I will also try to give you understanding on that books as well, which will be really very beneficial for you all. So thank you so much. Take care and keep watching my channel.